In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, the regular season winding down for the Blue Hose, and they split the pair of the last two games. We'll have a visit with Coach Greg Nybert, take a look at those highlights, and we'll preview the Big South Tournament. All that and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, along with Coach Greg Nybert. I'm your host, Eric Thacker. Thank you for spending part of your Saturday with us. If you are a Blue Hose fan, there's a chance you may still be in Buies Creek, meaning you're not watching this live. You are watching this on GoBlueHose.com. That's a good thing. As we have already started the conference tournament, we're going to talk about getting ready for the tournament, but since you're watching this live, we are actually in Buies Creek right now. So, Coach, let us go ahead and recap the last couple of games this season. One positive thing that you won back-to-back road games. That's huge in this conference. Let's talk about that first.
Well, it is, Eric, and especially with how, those two wins came about. You know, we played Liberty at Liberty, a couple Saturdays ago at their place. Mm-hmm. They had won 7 of 8 and probably 1 point away of being 8 in a row. And
that's right.
As I told our guys before the game, we put, really a great half together against UNC Asheville, where we had 33-19, right, and just didn't put a second half together. And for the team, we really lost 8 games in a row. And probably 5 of those games, we lost by 3 points or less and had a chance to win. So, this team could have been really, really down. The coach is really down. But we put our best 40 minutes together at Liberty and beat Liberty on their court. And then what an exciting game to go against a Longwood team. Oh, that it was their senior night, and right, very emotional senior night for all. They had 4 seniors, and we know how those things go. And to beat Longwood, which I picked Longwood in the top 3, I thought they were one of the best offensive teams in the league. They had about everybody back coming, back from right, the team that beat us in the tournament last year.
They could shoot,
too. They could shoot. They got one of the biggest big men inside. And for us to, hit that shot, and Will Adams to hit that shot at the last second, was a great win on the road against a very, very good basketball team.
And I'm just now getting my voice back. So thank you very much, Coach, for making us go nuts at the end. Let's talk about that huddle. The players are in last possession. The Blue Hose need to get a basket to win. They're in Farmville, Virginia. We were talking on the air, Reggie Dillard, DeShawn Murray. Reggie Dillard has already had the ball in his hands at the wire. And we were thinking it's either Reggie Dillard or it's DeShawn Murray. And then we forgot all about the heroic three-pointer that was made at Gardner-Webb with Will Adams. So was that designed? Was that, okay, we're going in and then we're going to kick it out at the same spot where Will hit that against Gardner-Webb?
Well, what we did, we ran a play here. Again, it's called kind of a roll and replace on-ball screen for Reggie with right, Ed. And then Reggie will drive the basketball. Ed rolls to the basket and we bring DeShawn up right off Ed's screen. So, Reggie, it's a read by Reggie. He drives it, and he drove it in there, and Will's man came off of him. So he threw it over there. He could have, hit Ed for the layup or thrown the ball back to DeShawn, which obviously putting the ball in his hands and Reggie's hands the last 2 or 3 seconds. But threw it down there to Will and ended up missing the shot. But an old school thing is, especially late in the year, you follow your shot. So he followed his shot and got that ball back. And couldn't be prouder of a guy in Will Adams that you say has come off the bench and then now starting and the 2 shots he's hit. And what a great job he's doing it for us and the whole team. So we're really excited.
Yeah, came right off. It was a good look. Came right off the front part of the rim, as you mentioned. Followed up and then went right back up. Got the kiss off the glass. With like 3/10 remaining, the shot left his hands before the window turned red. The refs came over, and while they were coming over, we were saying, oh, it's good, it's good. And it was. That was a great victory. Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you.
On that, on the 2 back-to-back road wins in this conference, very hard to do. Mm-hmm. We close out the season at home in the Templeton Center. We're getting ready for the conference tournament. Your guys spent a lot of emotion on those 2 wins on the road. Tell us about the matchup with High Point as we closed out the regular season.
Well, we knew, you know, it was a tough road. We decided to, you know, to spend the night, one more night at Longwood instead of getting in at 3 or 4 in the morning.
Right.
We did spend the night and got up early, 7 o'clock in the morning, and got on the bus by 8 and got home by here about 2. And then really went, some of our guys had tests that afternoon, so right. They went to their tests. And then we didn't really practice until 5 o'clock. So it wasn't a normal day, not to make excuses, but we went about 45 minutes maybe and walked through some things defensively. But we wouldn't really want to treat that game like a championship-style, you know, effort. You know, they were playing for first place as they'd beaten.
Right. They were motivated.
They were motivated. There's no doubt John Brown's hurt, and if they win the game, they win the championship. If they don't win the game, they don't win the championship.
Right.
So we surely challenged our guys, and we did have championship effort. We felt like in the first half it's 32-29, but, you know, unfortunately we didn't keep that up, whether a fatigue or getting tired sets in, but we didn't fly around in that zone. They hit some big threes, and they beat us, and they deserved the game. But we weren't ready to play a full 40 minutes again. We felt like we played a good half, but you got to put 40 minutes together, especially defensively against a really good, you know, team in High Point.
And we did see a couple of halves put together against Liberty and Longwood, the first half against Asheville, the first half against High Point. So I know what you're talking about, Coach. But overall, as we wound down the regular part of this season, our last four games, would you say that PC was playing its better basketball?
Oh, there's no question. And you know, we've only had Reggie Dillard at the point guard since basically February 18th when we played Asheville. And you know, for 2 weeks. And Will Adams and Janiel are starting along with Deshaun. And obviously Ed, and got a great bench coming off the bench with Darius and Devon and Marcus. And Jaron Withers is really doing a great job. Ruben.
Absolutely.
And got Austin Venable, who's really doing a nice job, and John Major's coming in there. So we're really excited about our bench and really excited about our new lineup.
All righty, Coach, let us go ahead and dive in and take a look at the highlights. We begin in Farmville, Virginia, the Lancers of Longwood.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, what's really good is you can see our start, and we've got our subs in there. Darius, still have Marcus is coming off the bench. Jaron's coming in there. Great pass there by Ed. Great pitch out there. And then Darius came off the bench and hit 2 threes, which was absolutely awesome for Darius. See, we're in the zone. We don't want the ball to go in the high post there. Great closeout and great contest. Great job by Will Adams there contesting that shot and coming up with that loose rebound. You can see that they've got a 10-point lead, which we led the entire time at Liberty. And for us to be down 10, again, there's Darius hitting a 3-point shot. Again, those are huge for a point guard to come in here.
Absolutely.
He can really shoot the basketball when he has his feet set. But we were down 10. They go to a little bit of a zone. We're moving the ball fast, right? Trying to get the ball inside there. It's a beautiful pass right there by Jaron. And great, you know, little shot there by Deshaun, who had a career high 34 points. Again, we'd like to get our hands up a little bit. Our hands are down. Good job there by Austin. Great contest by Austin. Great block out on the 6'8 kid by Deshaun, and we're pushing the basketball. Again, we're down 8. Again, great job throwing it inside. Freshman to freshman, all right? Again, now we're down 6. Start the second half here, still down about 6 points. Like to get a little more pressure on that ball. Great block out by Ed. We're pushing the ball with Janiel and Rhett. Pushing the ball down there, right there to Deshaun, as he had that little jump shot going for when he hits that 10 or 15 footer. And the high post jump shot. Again, we're running a little play here. Again, Reggie goes off the rim there, a little long. Ed comes up with the rebound. Again, they're all over Deshaun. Great pass in there, great extra pass. This is a great job by Ed using the rim against a 6'8 guy, what we call a Mike and drill. George Mike and using that rim. Great job of flattening the defense out, swinging the ball, sprinting over there, kind of missed the on-ball screen. Again, they're in zone. We get it right in the heart of the zone, and Deshaun goes in there and finishes over 6'8". You see, we now have the lead, so couldn't have been prouder of the guys to be down 10. That's where we showed some toughness and never give up. As We had the lead the whole time against Liberty. Different toughness here in this game. Again, Will was just a little off, but great offensive rebound there by Austin. You can see our two freshmen really helping us in this game. And really proud Austin. He had a tough first half and really challenged him the second half, and he made some big plays the second half and responded in a positive way. Again, on ball screen, Reggie shooting a pull up, and great. Give us the lead right back there. We're seesawing back. I think there were 6 lead changes. Well, here's the play right here. We want to get the ball inside there. Screen right there. Drive it. You can see Will's man's all the way in there. Follows his shot. Gets the rebound back. What an unbelievable shot right there as the buzzer went off. And you can see the bench and Coach Reynolds in there hugging on. Look at Janiel and everybody hugging on big Will. It was absolutely awesome. You can see Deshaun and the whole team in there. What a great win for a great, you know, great team. And everybody pulling in there for him. Tremendous, tremendous. Deshaun's still in there with it.
Coach, a couple of other things I want to talk about that game. Yes, Longwood, definitely some talent. You picked them preseason to finish third. Definitely senior-led. Wobo, one of the toughest guys down there on the post. But Deshaun Murray, again, offensively, a career-high 34 points. Also pulled down 8 or 9 boards in that contest. They scored 3 big-time threes in that first half, which gave them that 10-point lead. Mm-hmm. And the guy that hit those all of a sudden was not a factor in the second half because your guys were able to get out there on the shooters and contest those. The other point I want to make was Johnson had a great day for Longwood in terms of the assist, but PC forced him into many turnovers as well. So I thought it was a very good defensive effort by your Blue Hawks.
Well, it was, and it had to be, because I think they're one of the best offensive teams in the league.
Absolutely.
With Wobo down inside, Johnson going one-on-one. Right. They got 3 guards that can drive it and shoot it, and they obviously proved that their last game of the year against Radford on the road, and we're down 20 points and came back from down 20 with 12 or 13 minutes to go to win the game by 11. So I think they're getting it all together at the right time for the tournament, and they'll be one of the toughest teams to beat, especially offensively. And when they take care of the ball, which they did against Radford, I think they had 18 assists and 6 turnovers. They're a totally different team.
And we're going to talk more about this conference as a whole. I tell you what, you could put everybody's name on a piece of paper, just put it in a jar, and then pick one, because top to bottom, this thing is wide open, more than it's ever been. We'll preview that and have more from the coach. We'll also take a look at our Hustle Offensive and Defensive Players of the Week when we return right here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
Frosted lemonade, starting at 240 calories. This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Bojangles, It's Bow Time. And by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. And now it's time to take a look at our Offensive Player of the Week, brought to you by Swain Brown & Associates and Upstate Insurance Consultants.
Again, we're bringing up the ball up the floor here with Darius and Jaron, and they're in a little 2-3 zone, you can see, and we're moving the ball right there, kind of running a little bit of a play right there. Again, great screen by Deshaun, and great pass Darius, and a little lob play for Jaron, which is big against the zone to get a layup. But great execution by Darius and Deshaun setting that great screen.
Well, Coach, I was wondering where that highlight was. Picked the right time. Usually you would think Deshaun Murray, maybe an Ed Drew, but Jaron Withers making that play.
Yeah, we do. We got a little, you know, out of bounds or continuation of different some set plays. And sometimes he'll cut through and sometimes we'll go back there so they kind of don't know it's coming. So but great execution by, again, Darius making the pass and Deshaun setting that back screen and Jaron finishing that with the anytime you can get a layup against a 2-3 zone, it helps you.
All righty, Coach, let us go ahead and transition to our Defensive Player of the Week. And each and every week that is brought to you by our friend Steve Crow, who played basketball here at PC and has Foothills Motorsports.
Yeah, this is our Defensive Player of the Week. And you can see we're right in the game here, which, you know, they're in the 20s with 5 minutes to go. And right in this game, again, the guy comes back to steal the ball there. All right, and then watch the hustle play here by Janiel. Taking that unbelievable charge when the numbers weren't looking good, and that's what you're trying to do is take a charge there on the guy, which was a great hustle play there by Janiel Jenkins.
We featured him a couple of shows ago, Coach, and I tell you what, the lone senior on this basketball team, and hopefully he's still in action today as well.
Well, I hope he is too, and hope we are too, but really couldn't be prouder of Janiel, not only what he's done his hard-nosed and toughness, but for him to be working out his senior year, you know, and playing and really being an instrumental part of the success here that we've had, and he can really drive the ball, he hustles, he plays defense, and having him out there, him and Will Adams up at the top of that zone, and Reggie, and has really meant a lot to the team, and how hard he plays, and he brings that toughness, and that's what we're looking for, you know, in a player, and especially down the stretch.
Tell you what, thank you very much, number 10. All righty, Coach, let us go ahead and transition to our Hustle Play of the Week, and that's brought to you by another friend of PC, and that is our friend Dan Nunnery, who played and coached here with Greg Nyberg.
Well, you can see it's a tight ball game here. We're down one in the second half, and in that zone, they set an on-ball screen contest there by Deshaun and Reggie. Again, great defense leads the great offense, and Deshaun contesting that shot in the corner and being the first guy down the floor, running that floor, and what a great hustle play that was to contest. And then get the layup down there is just a sure hustle play, which we need from Deshaun, especially down the stretch.
Only fitting that we end the highlights there with Deshaun Murray, the player of the year and the first team, second team. All conference will be out in just a matter of a couple of days. But let us go ahead and spend time on number 3, Deshaun Murray, only a sophomore, has an opportunity to be voted as the player of the year in the conference. There's no doubt he's first team. But not only this year, this young man has an opportunity to be on top of a lot of categories before his career is done at Presbyterian College. This guy is a special one.
Well, he is, and there's no doubt he had a career-high 34 points, but after the game when I saw that, it was, you know, I couldn't believe that he had 34 points because it was the quietest, you know, 34 points, all within the system, you know, getting rebounds, running the floor, you know, shooting the high post jump shot and going one-on-one a few times.
And his performance at the foul line,
and
too.
Making those free throws was incredible. I think he was 14 for 16
and
really improved in that area, but you know, the thing that we you know, tell Deshaun, and he did it, is if you want to have a great game offensively, you have a great game defensively. And he was flying around in that zone and getting rebounds, as you can tell by the last highlight. All that started with a great contest, You know, and then he you know, and we got to have him doing that. You know, we can't really have one guy not playing defense. And, you know, when he plays hard on defense, he's one of the best offensive players because that comes natural to him. But what a player. And he'll do nothing but get better and better because he takes coaching. He responds to when he knows he made a mistake, whether it be passing the ball or in the double team, or he's got to play harder. And he's going to be the real key. Not his offense, really, I don't think, in the tournament. But I think his unbelievable defense in that zone that he's got to fly around out there. And I know he'll score just because that comes natural. And he's one of the best players in the league because he can score in so many different ways.
Offense, defense in terms of rebounding, but also stealing the basketball. He ranks second in the conference in steals. Let's go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we got to thank Palmetto Bone and Joy. Our kids have been healthy all year long. And our Bear Transport look ahead is going to be the conference tournament. We're going to break down the conference as a whole, one of the best mid-majors in the country, when we return here on Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut-rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
Mike, don't look now, but Dale Earnhardt Jr. is right behind you.
In Bojangles? Tim, Dale Jr. is right behind you.
I bet he is. Let me guess. He's getting a Diet Mountain Dew, and I bet he's got a two-piece dinner combo and Cajun Pintos.
Dirty rice, Tim. I got the dirty rice.
Head to Bojangles for a two-piece dinner combo with a Diet Mountain Dew. Bojangles.
It's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, it has been a phenomenal year in terms of the health of your Blue Hose. Thank you, Dr. Milner, and all the staff there at Palmetto Bone and Joint.
Well, no doubt about it, Eric, and it has been a blessful season, and injuries are a big part of seasons, and we've been blessed. We've had a few in the past couple of years with Reggie and things like that, and Deshaun's thumb, but right now going in the tournament, other than Jeff Gandy, Jeff's a walk-on, a red shirt, and he's had maybe some mono and some issues there that we will pray for him and make sure he ends up being back to good health. But we've been blessed overall.
Well, Coach, since we wound down the regular season and you touched on it real quick, tell us about the guys that come out, practice hard every day, and really make this team complete with what they do in practice.
Well, it's where it all begins. And that's where you write up your preparation and how well you practice and how well you play at practice is how you're going to do in the games. And our guys overall have really come to practice hard and play hard. It's been a total team effort. We got 16 guys on the team. Three or four of them don't get to play a whole lot, but they're over there
That's
cheering.
What I wanted to talk
you know,
about.
Charlie Inklin has been absolutely tremendous. Stephen Osu doing extra work.
Yes.
Unbelievable. And then we got Jeff Gandy and Harrison Burton, those four guys, and they're over there cheering on that bench. And what tremendous attitudes and great work ethics all of them have, and really proud of the whole entire team.
Well, thank you, those four gentlemen, heart and soul of the team as well, because they bring it every time to practice. Coach, we're winding down real quick. This conference tournament's wide open. Hopefully, we're still playing. Break it down for us.
Well, like you said, anybody can beat anybody. There's no doubt about it. I think for us, you know, that first game, as I told our guys on Thursday, and hopefully we're still playing, but that is the hardest game of the tournament. And we've got to play our best defensive game that we've played all year against a Radford team that was picked in the top three or four. That I think has one of the most talented, you know, teams in the league.
And we'd like to thank Bear Transport for that sponsorship all year long. Our look ahead, conference tournament time. Greg, thank you for joining us once again, and hopefully we will see you again. And hopefully we're playing today on Saturday. For Coach Greg Nybert, I'm Eric Thacker. Thank you for joining us. Till we see you again, go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by
Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College. Like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors: The Bud Group, Good Times Entertainment, Carolina Concrete, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Midway Barbecue, Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning, Epting Turf and Tractor, Arthur State Bank, Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton, Wilson's Cafe, Tony's Pizza, and Steamer's Cafe.